So don't be surprised if you hear them shout. Cut your trousers up inside out. Go, go, dig down, dog.
And welcome to Da Bungalow. My name is Dickity Dickity Dick.
And my name is Dominy Dominy Dom.
Hey! Dickity Wickity Woo Wah.
Dominy Dominy Doo Da.
Dick.
Dominy Dom.
Dick. So that's the kind of thing you're going to expect from Da Bungalow over the next few months, right?
Yeah, it's an absolutely amazing place. And I'll tell you what, here's a secret, yeah? Here's a secret, guys. We have lived in this bungalow for years and years and years.
Tell them how many years?
A million years. We've actually, in fact, we first came here when we were knee high to a gnat. So we're as high as a gnat's knee. You know what I mean?
Whatever that is. Hey, do you want to have a look around our bungalow? Do
yes,
you? Do you? Do
of course
yeah?
you? Do.
Come on. This is the living room. Yeah. What about that?
That's so beautiful.
Look at the tissue box.
Beautiful, eh?
Comfy sofa. You can always just have a little sit down and, yes. and chill out.
And this is our little friend, Bongo Bell. He doesn't actually make any noise.
He doesn't mind. Bongo. Hey, look, Grandad Dick's here.
Oh, come and have a look at Grandad Dick. Oh.
Look at his furry beard, isn't it nice? Hey, yes, this is actually my auntie's brother's goldfish's goat's granddad.
Yeah, no, it is. And by the way, you can actually spot Grandad Dick in the street. Yeah. He's very small, pink and wrinkly. So if you see him in the street, just say, hello, Grandad Dick. His head's fallen out.
Yes, oh, I love it.
Sorry
come on,
about
this
him.
Is Da Bungalow.
Let's come over here.
Over here, check him out. It's the moose's head.
Yes.
Moose, this, what's he going to do?
This.
Going to be careful. Oh, hey,
now, this is Moose's head. You guys are going to ask him any question, and all
Please
he says.
Shut up!
All he does is burp back to you. In fact.
Ask him a question, Thomas. Ask him a question.
What do you. What do you prefer? Shut up!
Shut up! Just right. shut up!
Wait. Do you prefer. Moose or yogurt? What do you prefer? Moose or yogurt?
Now he doesn't want to say anything.
Stupid.
Right, moving on, Tom.
I'm so disgusted, I'm going to go to the toilet.
Hey, look, come over here. This is the airing cupboard. Every week we have a little person inside the airing cupboard getting boiling hot because there's the heater, and they air their views on a certain subject. Maybe you want to air your views on Dom's stripy shirt today because I'm not too keen on his shirt. Or maybe you want to air your views on what Dom says because sometimes he does cross that line. Or if you want to air your view on any subject, I'll give you the contact details in a bit. Over here, it's the kitchen. Come and have a look at the kitchen. Now, in the bungalow, never ask questions. Why is the window slanted? Why is the cupboard on an angle? Don't ask. It just is. In the kitchen, we have a one plate. Like this. I'm going to make you a little dish here. We have one can of shaving foam. You get the shaving foam, you squirt it on the plate like so. You make a custard pie. Now, if any of our little people that join us in the bungalow, or Dom, he gets on my nerves, what you do is just literally in the face. There you go. That is the kitchen. Now, Dominic is in my favourite part of the bungalow. It's the lav, Mr. Dominic Wood, in the lav.
Oh, sorry. Hello there. Hello, everybody. Yeah, this is the toilet. And what am I doing in a toilet, I hear you ask? What are you doing in the toilet with me? Who are you? Sorry. No, this is where Turtle's head happens. Yeah, Turtle's head. You know when you're in the toilet and suddenly Turtle's head rears its ugly head? Well, here is Turtle's head. There it is. Hello, Dom. Right, get back down, you vicious beast. Come on, get back down. Right, staying there. Turtle's head will be telling some ridiculous jokes later on. Anyway, from me in the toilet, it's over to Dick.
You enjoying it? It's good, isn't it, this place? This is Da Bungalow with Dick and Dom, live on the CBBC channel. This is our TV. This is where we watch our programmes. Programmes like Ivana the Yukon. In the attic, we found something called Rent-A-Ghost. That's on later. U-Boss as well. This is the TV. Bit 1950s, isn't it? But we like. Oh, and our little gnome as well. I was in the lab, mate. Nice.
Absolutely fantastic. So there we are. That is the bungalow.
Yep.
And you guys can actually get in contact with us as well. Yeah, you can do indeed. All you can do, if you want to ask us a question maybe, or if you've got any problems, you think we can help you, if you want to play a game or win some prizes, all you have to do is call this number.
Dial this Samantha Mamba number 0845 900 222, 0845 900 222. Here it is, mate.
That's give us a call right away. Press 6 and you'll get straight through to the bungalow.
Or you can email. We have our very own email address. Give us a new. Yes, bungalow@bbc.co.uk. It's even got the name of our programme in it. Give us
now.
Bungalow at BBC. bbc.co.uk.
Do you know what I mean? Pretty good. Take the phone back.
Right, time to meet our little friends.
Yeah, our friends. Every single week on a Saturday and a Sunday, we have a posse, a crew, a group of kids who come in here. You guys who come in here and join us. Yeah, and you guys can do exactly the same. But we've got them sorted out for this weekend. Let's meet them.
Let's meet them. Okay, I'm opening the door. Let's find out who the first person into Bungalow is.
Hello, this is Hannah. Hannah is 11 years old and she's from Caterham. She tries to communicate with ghosts and has a pet dog called Dom, whose nickname is Mongo. Mongo Dom. Well done, Hannah. Thank you very much.
She didn't look like she believed any of that, did she?
Okay. So go on, your turn.
Who's next in the bungalow? It's James! Come on, James. There he is.
Nice one, James. This is James.
He's 12 from Betchworth. He really wants a pet kangaroo. Is that true?
Yes.
That is true. We've been doing our research. And you're also known to sneeze over 20 times when you get up in the morning.
True?
Yes.
True!
Disgusting little monkey. Go and sit down.
Go and make yourself comfy.
Next up is Damien. Damien over here. Hello, Damien. How are you?
I'm fine.
Good. Now, Damien can moonwalk and he can also tie his limbs in a knot. True?
Yeah.
We'll get you to do a demonstration later. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Off to the sofa. Off you go.
Damien! And next, it's Serena. This is Serena, who's 11 years old from Croydon. You can crack your nose, I hear.
Yeah.
Can you?
Yeah.
We'll give a demonstration later on.
You also can't eat sweets while you wear your brace.
That's true, yeah.
We'll be playing a game with sweets later, but they won't be
Serena, everyone, a lovely pink Serena. Who's next?
Next up is Luke. Luke where? Luke here, Luke there, Luke everywhere, Luke here. And Luke can burp on command, can you?
Yep.
Very quickly go. Disgusting.
Oh,
and also,
yes.
Luke can do an impression of a pigeon. Very quickly, pigeon.
Woo!
Absolutely
yes.
Rubbish. There you go. Go and sit down. Thank you very much, Luke.
Grand old man. And last but not... Ooh, it's the doorbell. Hello, it's Anu. It is last. It's Anu.
Anu.
Anu is 11 years old from Croydon, and you're afraid of bridges.
Yes,
correct?
Yes.
Why bridges?
Because I always think they're going to break.
Oh, well, there are no bridges near to Bungalow.
So off you go.
Thank you very much.
They are the Bungalow...
Posse!
The Bungalow Heads!
Let's go and join them over here. Hello, let's go around the back of the sofa and go and join you. Right, okay, guys, now you know what? You guys are going to be here on Saturday and Sunday, aren't you? Yeah? And if you guys behave yourselves and you get enough bungalow points, you can win a star prize. Have a look at this.
It's the prize! Ooh.
Have a look. Can you see the star prize? It's beautiful. It's as if it's just been sent to us. Anyway, listen, you guys can win that if you get the most amount of bungalow points. And bungalow points are awarded to you guys if you do anything, okay?
Now, if you do something really good, like show us one of your hidden talents that you we were telling you about up there, then you could win, say, 100 bungalow points.
Yeah.
But if you do something bad to us that we don't like, we can take those bungalow points away whenever we are. We're going to give you an example now. Let's do it with you, James. James, how old are you?
12,
correct. You just earned yourself, James, for telling the correct answer there. 10 bungalow
well
points.
Well done, James. James. Okay, now, here's another example, okay? This is for you, Anu, okay? Are you ready?
Yes.
Here's a picture of a random man, okay? How old do you think he is? Come on!
39.
Afraid he's 38.
It's longer.
So therefore you have 50 bungalow points deducted from you for not knowing his age.
So you've actually got minus 50 bungalow points, Annie. So should we have a look at the scoreboard now and see what happens? See what lead they're in? No, we can't have a look at that now, but James has got 10 bungalow points and Anu is obviously last because he's got minus 50 bungalow points.
And that's how it kind of works in a roundabout sort of way.
Sort of way. Anyway, everybody, come over to the banana because we're all going to sit down and sit and watch the TV now.
Come over here. Sit on the banana. Come on, make yourself nice and comfy.
Make yourself comfy. Lovely.
Okay, let's fancy watching some of this. Let's just put this
Fancy watching a bit of Yvonne of the Yukon, everyone?
Your Highness, to make the perfect ham omelette, you need the perfect ingredients.
Such a thing cannot be tolerated. Nothing covers the face of King Louis. Do you understand?
and buzzing!
Much better!
There once was a Frenchman, Yvonne was his name. Exploring new worlds, he dreamed was his fame. But reading a map was not his forte. So poor Yvonne was soon cast away.
Yvonne, how will you come?
Sailing the stormy seas.
Yvonne, how will you come?
No one could hear his pleas.
He soon found himself in a bit of a pickle.
The frigid North Seas proved more than fickle.
Yvonne's navigation would soon cost a price.
He was knocked overboard
and turned into ice.
Yvonne, how will you come?
Hapless volunteer.
Yvonne, how will you come?
Frozen for hundreds of years. 300 years passed, and with some irony,
his scheme was thought out by Mutt's need to pee.
Yvonne claimed the land for his country's glory, and that's the start of Yvonne's story.
Yvonne, how the Yukon,
frozen by icy seas.
Yvonne, how the Yukon,
defrosted for you and for me.
So, you dare to submit form number 23A without the proper signatures. Get ready for pain. In triplicate. Had enough? Or must I use the three-hole punch of doom? Tidwell, Department of Yukon Affairs.
Tidwell, Beamish, got your reports.
Yes, sir.
Looks like you're running a tight ship up there and up your dump truck.
Thank you, sir. That would be up your mucklug, sir.
Anyway, we're thinking of using it in this year's Yukon It's Sort of Okay tourist campaign. So I'm coming up for a look-see. It better be a bastion of law and order, or you're scrawny necks on the chopping block.
Yes, sir. Don't worry, sir. Everything is exactly... Aw, not the way you think it is. Oh, boy. Law and order, huh? Things look pretty good to me. On the other hand... Children, stop that fighting! You there! You with the dog! Don't you realize that animal should be on a leash?
Uh-huh.
Yow!
Yeah?
Achoo!
You sneezed!
You owe me a big Eddie!
I beg your pardon? Don't tell me you two are gambling with snacks.
Okay, we won't!
Hey!
A happy man, although my face looks like a clam. And it ain't much fun till the job gets done. And mon Dieu, this is impossible.
How can Yvonne make repairs without the proper tools?
Bastion of law and order. There's no order here at all. What has happened to this town?
Thank you.
Young lady, this town is infested with lawbreakers, not to mention a flagrant disrespect for authority.
Anyone killed or maimed?
No.
Trading in bear parts, moose antlers, or spotted owled gizzards? Civil unrest, acts of terrorism, or a widespread disease and famine?
Not exactly.
Oh, geez, well then what's the problem?
I should have known. You're just like the rest of them. Well, you haven't heard the last of Willie Tidwell, young lady, and that you can count on. Someday, a cleansing blizzard is going to fall and wash away all the garbage and the scum. I will not be intimidated. Aw, this is crazy. I'm no cop. And what peace officer in his right mind would want to come to a place like this? Wait a minute. Unemployed police officer seeks meaningful law and order work. I believe this country is going to the dogs. Write care of this magazine or email to nomoreguff.com. Yeah. Dear nomoreguff.com, I hear what you're saying.
Vaughn, what's with all the stuff?
I have a hole in the wall, and the hardware fellow recommends the power tools.
Are you sure you know what you're doing? I mean, have you ever used the power tools before?
Tools are tools. Perhaps Dummy does not realize that Vaughn was considered the most famous artisan back in France.
Do you know what you're doing?
Of course. When the chain is stiff, I take the hammer and...
What are you doing, you madman?
There is nothing worse than a wobbly throne, Your Highness. The wobble? She is gone.
I guess I didn't realize you knew so much.
You see? You'd be surprised at how little Yvonne knows. Just remember, anyone in town needs repairs, give Yvonne the signal.
Okay, I'll let them know. Come on, let's get something to eat.
And here it is, Article 19, Paragraph 6. No pointy moose antlers above public doorways. You see? And there they are.
What moose?
I demand that people show me some respect around here. Ow! Knock it off! None of you will have Willie Tidwell to kick around anymore. And do you know why?
Yeah, it's the cinnamon buns. And, you know, they're just the best ones I ever...
Well, go ahead and guess why.
It's an earthquake! Run!
Everyone, meet Major Sweetly. He's the new law in town. Go. One pocket edition of the Yukon Rules, Regulations, and Bylaws.
That is not necessary. I have it memorized.
Memorized?
I will show you. Section 41, Article 13. No entertainment for prisoners.
Jeepers! What happened to Sassy?
Sit down or die.
Then again, I can always catch up with them reading.
You know, Tidwell, I've been to 1,000 towns like this one.
I believe you. I really do.
Cold, lifeless, nowhere places with insignificant little people who think they can get away with anything.
That's this place, all right. If you need anything, just holler.
Yvonne prefers his own tools.
One lone man facing a town filled with evil. You know, Betty, it's times like this that make it all worthwhile. Don't you agree?
You're an idiot!
No, you're the idiot!
Oops!
Teenagers, you are under arrest for the dangerous misuse of underwear.
But we were just goofing around!
Wow!
Can't you read the sign?
What's that?
It says no loitering.
Hey, I'm gone!
It also says no running away from the scene of a crime.
What crime?
Resisting arrest.
Who's resisting arrest?
All right, fella, I've just about had enough of you. Hold her there, lady. You always hog two parking spaces.
I'm not even driving.
Uh-huh. Try telling that to the judge.
Huh? Whoa, what is going on?
It's called progress, Tidwell.
But you've got half the town in there.
Don't worry, I'll get the rest later. You see, Tidwell, I have a vision. I see a world. No, a universe of law and order where decent taxpayers can live without sap-sucking, toe-biting, bottom-feeding lowlifes like these.
Look, I gotta pick up this Beamish guy in Dawson, so I'll be back in a couple of days, okay? Great working with you, Major.
Willie!
Willie, put down that piece of walrus meat and get us out of here.
But you can't leave.
Now, Tommy, Willie is the government agent, and what he says goes, which in this case happens to be me. I can't stay where I'm not needed. Besides, think about it. How bad could a guy like Major Sweetly be?
You're under arrest for having smelly furniture.
Ow! No!
For being ugly. For being too scenic. Too small. Too happy. A tad overweight. Ooh, toenails need clipping. Bed hair.
Mutt, what is it? What's going on? The Twister coming? Aliens have landed? Jimmy's in the well? Everyone's been thrown in jail, including Dad? Holy smokes, we gotta do something! Dad!
Huh? Tommy!
Major Sweetly, I demand that you release these people immediately!
Of course. But don't you want to inspect them first?
Tommy, stay out. It's a trick.
Rats.
They think I'm crazy. They're the crazy ones. I'll shoot them who's crazy.
We're doomed. Wait a minute. Yvonne, he'll save us.
Like I said, we're doomed.
No way! If I know him, he's probably working on a plan to free us right now!
Yeehaw!
Sassy daylight.
Hey,
Hey! What the?
Sorry. I panicked.
Wait! There's a flare gun in my desk drawer. If we can reach it, we can send a signal out the window. Quick, give me your belts.
It is a signal! Someone is in need of an artisan!
Incoming! Incoming! Enemy on the move! Check for flag gun! Check for flag gun!
All of you have disobeyed the rules and must be punished! No more rations forever!
What?
You're mad!
You mean angry mad or crazy mad?
Where is everyone? Well, never mind. When Yvonne gets a signal, he will find something to fix. Like the damaged sidewalk outside the bingo barn!
Aha! Unlawful repair of civic property. I have you now, my irritating little friend. Little man, prepare to meet your...
No!
Wow, great service.
Hey, that's mine!
Gunnut impersonate officer? Holy mackerel! Sweetly's not even a cop! Well, somebody's gonna warn Yvonne!
Without the mixing stick. Sacre bleu! This is the biggest power tool Yvonne has ever seen! But where does she plug in?
Monsieur,
I must say, if this is your power tool, she is a beauty.
Well, here we are, sir. The most peaceful, law-abiding town in the Yukon.
Tidwell, I'm considering a change of plans.
Yvonne, it's looking great.
And to Tommy, a grand merci for lending Yvonne a hand.
Yvonne, you never told me how it got wrecked in the first place.
Well, Tommy, to make an omelette, you have to break a few eggs.
It's Dick and Dom in the Bungalow. We do like a bit of Yvonne of the Yukon, don't we, guys? Very good, very good.
Absolutely amazing. I tell you what, do you want to watch someone else as well?
Yeah.
Do you want to watch someone else?
Yeah.
Okay, Yvonne, more Yvonne tomorrow. But in the meantime, let's see what's on. Hang on, go. Here we are.
Who's that? That's Bruce Forsyth.
Bruce Forsyth, look at him.
In the canteen.
That's Janice Battersby.
From Coronation Street.
Oh, hang on.
What's going on here?
What are they doing? That's disgusting. I'm sorry about these guys. They've got no dignity whatsoever. They could come into the BBC and start having a fight. Look, hang on, wait. Oh, no!
She's eating his leg.
Hey, that's disgusting. Is that similar to a boxer or something?
Oh, no, man.
Mike
terrible.
Tyson. Oh! The wig's gone.
Hold on a minute. I recognise that face.
I tell you what, forget that. Okay. Yeah. Now, listen. Damien. Anu. We quite cruelly took away 50 bungalow points.
Yeah, we'll just explain. Yes. These are our bungalow heads. Every Saturday and Sunday morning, we have bungalow heads in the studio to help us out.
Yeah.
And they make us cups of tea and be our slaves for the day and all that kind of thing. And if they do something good, we award them bungalow points. If they do something bad, we take away their bungalow points.
Yeah, okay. Now, we took away 50 points from Anu earlier. It was a bit cruel as we were just explaining the rules. But Anu, here's your chance to win 51 bungalow points.
Yeah.
Rich, take it away. Not Bruce, but the other one.
Okay, right. All you're going to do, Anu, is get your tongue, put it inside your mouth like that. Get your ears like this. Got them?
Ready?
Do it. Get your ears, and go like this. Yeah!
Right, fantastic. There you go. I tell you what, it was good. You deserve 51 bungalow points, but you spat all over Rich, so you lose one, so you've got... Nil in total. He's got 0 points.
No bungalow points.
Back to zero. There you go.
Now, on the bungalow, it's time to play the boingy boingy game. Boing up,
boing up,
zero.
Boing up, boing up.
And three of you over here. Yes, you, Damien and James, over here.
Okay,
and
you three
this
over
is the
here.
Boingy Boingy game where Dom of the Yukon is ready on the trampette in the garden. Where is he?
Is he there?
Hello.
No,
where is
no.
he?
Oh, there he is. Dom of the Yukon.
With those fetching blue pants again.
Viewers, I'm very sorry about those blue pants. They're not very nice. We'll try and get that resurrected.
We got two callers on the line, and what's going to happen is they're going to decide how many bounces Dom's going to do on the trampette before he bounces off, sprains his ankle, and sits in Hammersmith A&E department for 4 hours.
Which I actually had to do.
So our two callers are Louis, firstly. Hello, Louis.
Hello, Dick and Dom.
Hey.
How are you doing?
Are you enjoying the bungalow?
Yes, wicked. Yeah. I like your bungalow.
Yeah, come on. Say hello to Louis, everyone. Big it up to Louis.
Yeah.
All right, then. Now, listen, playing for our team over here, this is the Dom team. That's the Dick team,
Dick team.
With Louis. And over here, the Dom team, we've got Paige Hopcroft. Paige, you there?
I am.
You are? Hello, how are you?
I'm fine.
You're all right. And where are you from?
Harrow.
Where are you from?
Harrow.
Where are you from?
Harrow.
Where are you from?
London.
Oh, you're from Harrow. Sorry. Okay. You three, look at Paige and say, Harrow. Nice one. Okay, now we've done that,
okay.
We're going to move on.
Right,
that's our team.
Look at the prize you could win. Yes, this. Ooh. It's the outrageous game with all
Turn
kinds
around.
Of fun stuff. Oh, the wrong way around. There we are. The outrageous game with all kinds of fun stuff. Yes, one of you will be winning that. So, over. Right, what we're going to do firstly is, Louie, you've got to decide how many times you think Dom will bounce before he jumps off the trampette. How many times do you reckon?
I think about 19 he could do.
19?
What are you going to have for breakfast, for goodness sake?
19? 19?
All right, then. Let's ask Paige Hopcroft from Harrow. Paige Harrow from Hopcroft. Harrow Paige from Hopcroft.
Harrow.
Whatever. Paige, how many bounces do you think Dom of the Yukon's going to do?
22.
19 and 22?
You think
right.
I'm a week
okay, over to Dom of the Yukon to find out how many bounces he'll do. Take it away, sir. Oh, he's limbering up. There he goes. Oh, yes. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. We win! We said 19! We're the closest! Yo! You win this game! Look at that!
Wicked!
We'll put that in the post here. Ooh.
Nice
Thanks,
one.
Dick and Dom.
Yeah, see you later.
Nice one.
Take it easy today. Sounds like you need to.
That means as well, mate, I'm sorry, guys, my team get 5 bungalow points each for winning. So 5 for James, 5 for Damien, and 5 for Anu.
Well done.
Come
well
on,
done,
the
guys.
Dick team.
Why don't you guys all take a pew on the banana, okay? Take a pew on the banana, and we'll talk about dressing up your granny.
Well, what we'll say, firstly, is that the Boingy Boingy game will be back next week here on the bungalow. Blah 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 blah
blah. Here, what do you call a man who doesn't sink? Bob.
What?
Now, this is a new item called Dress Up Your Granny.
Yes. Yeah.
Have you ever dressed up your granny?
No, I
dressed up my granny once as a reindeer at Christmas. It was very funny.
Very polite. She had a moose's head.
She did.
Well, makes no difference. She looks like a moose anyway.
Leave it.
There we are.
Right, this is two of our mates' grannies, actually. Now, this is Granny Doreen. She's dressed up as a cowboy. Look at that.
Isn't she sweet? She's got a bit grey around her teeth now, and her eyes are looking a bit saggy.
And down here is Granny Hilda.
Granny Hilda. She dresses as a red Indian there, and look at that cowboy with her chaps on.
Yeah.
Not the first time she's had a chap on. No.
So the challenge for you guys this week is to get your granny and dress her up, basically, as a cowboy or a red Indian. Easy as that. Take a photo and send it into this address.
Here's the address.
It is Dress Up Your Granny.
Da Bungalow.
Da Bungalow, by the way.
Not the Bungalow.
Da Bungalow. P.O. Box 9989, London, W12 7RJ. Get dressing up your granny, and your picture could be live here on the CBBC channel. Here's what's still to come this morning on Dick and Dom in the Bungalow. Let's have a look.
We got all these programmes.
We got Chuckovision, yes, our heroes. Oh, yes, come on, the Chucker brothers.
Oh, absolute heroes. Also, exclusive to the bungalow, we've got Looney Tunes. You don't see them anywhere else.
And check this out. We found this in the attic of the bungalow. We dusted the cobwebs off. It's Rent-A-Ghost. Live here on the bungalow later.
Hey, listen, and also, if you guys want to email us about anything you want, if you want to email us about the programmes that we've got here, what you think of the bungalow, what you think of the programme so far, and what you think of us, all you have to do is email us at this address. It's bungalow at bbc.co.uk. It's at the bottom of the screen. If you've got a computer, we want to know how many people are watching us right now.
There's the phone number as well, 08459002222, 08459002222. Ask Mission Dark carefully. When you get through, press number 6 and you'll get right through here to the bungalow. Right, little people, we've got another little challenge for you here, and we're going to give it to Luke. Right, Luke. This is your challenge. This is your challenge to win 15 bungalow points, which is not bad, eh? What you're going to do for about the next 15 minutes is talk in this language.
Blah, 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 blah.
So if we ask you a question like, what is your name? The answer would be...
Blah, 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 blah.
So,
do you understand?
So,
yeah.
No, you don't say yeah. You say... Blah, 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 blah. Do you understand?
Blah, 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 blah.
Okay, good.
So what is your name?
Blah, 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 blah.
How old are you?
Blah, 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 blah.
Well, what program's on next?
Well, that's where you're wrong, you see,
you're
because
wrong.
It's not blah, 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 blah. It's actually...
It's Looney Tunes. Do you like Looney Tunes?
Yeah.
Do you like it?
Looney Tunes at home? Yes. Right, let's have a bit of Looney Tunes. Whack it in, Dom.
And before we press play, one last word from our sponsor.
Blah, 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 blah. Can any of you do that? Go on. That's all, folks. Okay, enough now. Shut up.
What we're going to do in a minute, we're going to deduct a bungalow point from each of you because that was all noisy and rubbish.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay?
But not yet.
Not yet.
These are the bungalow heads. Say hello, bungalow heads.
Hello.
Now, these guys stay with us on Saturday and they stay with us on Sunday. And they do, guys. And throughout the whole time that they spend here, they can earn bungalow points. And the one, I can't believe it. And the one with the most amount of bungalow points at the end of their session here, they win this.
It's a bungalow.
Oh,
short time.
Oh, yeah, get off, about that. Leave it.
Yeah, so they basically went, well, tell them what they went, I don't know.
Widescreen TV, DVD player, DVD, what about that then? Right, let's have a look at the Bungalow scoreboard so far. Annie's got five points.
Pretty
nice
good.
One, Annie. Serena with nothing. And James with 15. James is in the lead at the moment.
Let's have a look at the next three. We got Luke, nothing. Damien, 5. Hannah, 0. Well done, zero. James. You are the man in the lead.
Well done indeed.
And Luke, how do you feel?
Yes! Yeah. Remember, you can get 15 points for keep speaking in the blah, 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 blah language blah, for the next blah, 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 10 minutes. Right, guys, if you want to go and settle down on the sofa for a bit, we'll watch Chucklevision in a bit. And me and Dom are going to say rhubarb, 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 rhubarb.
And chicken. No. Ah, hello, lovies. I'm Diddy Dick.
And I'm Diddy Dum.
Yes, he's Diddy Dum.
And he's Diddy Dick.
Love it.
Love it. Do you know what? We used to be stars of the West End, didn't we, Dickie?
Yes,
we used to be absolutely huge. He was in Mamma Mia. I was in Starlight Express. Yes, we used to be huge. Now look at us. Now look at us. Yes, just living in this rotten old cupboard.
But I'll tell you what, lovey. Shall we show them what we can do best?
Oh, yes. Come on. Strike up the band.
We're Diddy Dick and Dum. Welcome to our cupboard. We've lived here all our lives and never been discovered. We might be really small, but we've both got big hearts. It's all right in here, so long as no one... There's no room to swing a cat. A barely room to hang your hat. But there's no need to push and shove. Because we got cupboard love. Cupboard love. Cupboard love. It ain't no palace, but it feels like a glove. There's no need to push and shove. Because we got it covered like old Mother Hubbard.
Yeah,
we got cupboard love.
Rhubarb, rhubarb, rhubarb. Did you just hear something coming from that cupboard over there?
Mice.
Mice. Yes, but like
mice traps.
Yeah.
Mice traps, mouse's trap, meese's trap, moose's trap.
Thank you so much.
Right.
Now, time for a new item called Spotted Dick. Basically, I go around every city in England and Scotland and Wales, Northern Ireland, Ireland.
Blimey.
And I say to you, do you know who I am? Do you?
Most of you out there probably don't, but some of you actually do. And Dick goes and asks 10 different people, and we actually find out how famous he really is. How famous do you think you are?
This famous?
Well, let's start off by finding out how famous you are in the city of... Nottingham! Here, have a look.
I'll tell you what, Dom, you are now as nearly as short and fat and hairy as my microphone, mate. I'm in Nottingham, where once upon a time, people used to spot Robin Hood on the streets of the town. But today, can they spot Dick? Ah. Excuse me, do you know who I am? Yeah. Ah. Right, I'm in the busiest area of Nottingham where I'm sure everyone watches Dick and Dom in the Bungalow, so let's go and see if I can get spotted. Excuse me, come back. Hello, do you know who I am?
Yeah.
What's my name? Oh. Hello there, madam. Do you know who I am?
No, I don't. I'm from Australia.
Thank you so much. Yeah, your brain working, come on. Hello, do you know who I am?
The guy from the TV, I don't know.
Can't say the guy from the TV, what's the name?
Richard, I don't know.
Yeah! You officially spotted Dick here in Nottingham, thank you so much. I can hear it working, you know that name, it's in there, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, what is it then?
Simon for Blue Peter.
No! Sorry, madam, why don't you buy any paper there? Can I just ask you a question? Do you know who I am?
No.
Do you know who I am? Look at me.
Richard.
You have officially spotted Dick. Just the name, that's all we're looking for. Come on. Hi there, girls. Do you know who I am?
Yeah.
What's my name?
Not telling you.
Not telling me? Come on, you could get one of these stickers, please. What's my name? Come on. Yes, mum knew, right, or grandma knew. Grandma, there you go. That was a compliment, there you go. You spotted Dick in Nottingham, thank you so much. Well, that's 2 minutes.
2 minutes, hello.
Hello there. Do you know who I am?
Yeah.
What's my name?
Dick.
Yo, you spotted Dick too. There you go, nice one. Hello, do you know who I am? Do you know who I am? Don't hide. What's my name? That's all you have to say to the microphone. What's my name?
Go on.
Dick. Dick! You officially... You didn't want your face shown, but you spotted Dick. Nice one. You lot. Do you know who I am?
No.
Yeah. What's my name?
Dick.
Dick! You officially... Ready? Spotted Dick on Dick and Dom in the Bungalow.
What's the first name that's coming into your head? Say it.
YCM.
A what?
YCM.
YCM?
Yeah.
YCM.
Well, I might not be as famous as Robin Hood, but six people of Nottingham spotted Dick. And remember, I might be in a town near you soon.
Yes, some people like Dick, but some people didn't out there in Nottingham. Yes, let me introduce myself. My name is Professor Pink and Floppy. Yes, my hair, that is, all pink and floppy. Now, I'm going to do a very careful analysis on Dick and how popular he is and how much of a celebrity he is. Okay, over here, first of all, let's get the Dick pie chart out. Here we are, the Dick pie. There we are. There he is, this is Dick, and let's find out how much of a celebrity he is. Well, some people recognise him, but this many people didn't. So that makes him this... This famous. Good, okay, now listen up, class. If he's this famous, that means you probably have a group of friends similar to this. A load of grotty smelly students, the kind that like to watch Rent-A-Ghost. There you go, there's the guy. Okay, and you probably live in one of these houses, probably somewhere in Grimsby. Very nice, at least it's got its own front door. Windows need a bit of clean, never mind. And he'll probably drive a car like this. Now, let's do a careful analysis and let's work everything up. A car like that, friends like that. He'll probably be as famous as a celebrity like Stephen Gately. There he is. Oh, wonderful chappy he is. There we go. Dick, that's how popular you are. There'll be more spotted Dick. Oh.
Oh, brilliant, mate. Brilliant. Oh, yeah. Professor Pink and Floppy back next Saturday for more spotted Dick. I can't believe only six people knew who I was. Anyway, guys, over here, back to the banana, because we're going to watch another programme.
Back to the banana, sit on the banana.
Yeah, you sit in the middle.
Move the map out of the way.
Everyone's sitting comfortably.
Okay, everybody's got to start doing this.
Oh.
Do it.
Oh, go on.
It's our heroes. Oh. It's our heroes. It's the Chuckle Brothers.
Right.
It's Chuckle Vision.
Stop the mic. Play.
The Chuckle Brothers.
You can't build anything without proper planning, you know.
Oh, yeah, but it's only a bird table.
Only a bird table? You've got to be specially careful with bird tables.
Do you? Why?
Well, you can't just build them anywhere. They might collapse.
Oh, dear.
Yeah, and you know what happens if they collapse? The birds will stop trusting us.
Oh, dear.
Yeah, pretty soon they'll stop trusting everybody. They won't go to anybody's gardens anymore.
Oh, dear.
And then who'll be there to eat the earthworms? The earthworms will eat all the plants and the flowers and the shrubs. And then it'll start the greenhouse effect.
The greenhouse effect?
Yeah.
What's the greenhouse effect?
Everybody will start building greenhouses.
Oh, to keep out the earthworms.
Exactly. And then there'll be no parks, no shrubs, no grass, just greenhouses everywhere. It'll be a national disaster.
Oh, we better be careful then.
Exactly. Now, come on, let's go and have a look at the drawings. Hey. Now that's what I call a bird table.
Paul?
Sun lounge, patio, fully fitted kitchen. I've even put a television in the bedroom.
Yeah, but does it have to be so complicated?
Of course it does, if you want to attract the best birds. Now, where's those drawings?
Oh, they're down here.
Oh, right.
Now, there's one of you banging your finger with the hammer. There's one when you tripped over the tape. And this is my favourite. It's when you sat down in that puddle.
I don't mean those drawings, I mean the plans.
Oh, there they are.
Right. Now then, I think we should put the bird table just there.
Right.
I think that's...
There you go.
Not there. They're outside.
Oh.
silly you. Was it? Hey, come back! You can't put that there.
Yeah, but I thought you'd look nice here because the green grass matches the furniture.
You haven't got planning permission. And you can't go round building willy-nilly.
We've not built a willy-nilly. It's a bird table.
Just take it inside. Oh, be careful.
Hey, you've just seen our first bird. A duck.
Here
we are. This is where we get planning permission, look.
We want to save the marsh
brothers. Okay, bring it in, will you, please? Hey, Paul, can you give me a hand with this, please? Thank you. Okay, Barry. What do you want? We've got to take it in there, okay? To you, then. To me, Paul. To me. To you, Barry. To me, Paul. To me. Oops. I wish you'd be more careful, Paul. Sorry, Barry. I can't trust you to do anything, Paul, can I?
Barry.
And don't answer back, Paul, when I'm talking to you.
Barry.
I said don't answer back when... Oh, hello, Paul.
What are you doing?
Well, I was just, It's a great model, isn't it?
Come on, we've got work to do.
Hang on.
What is it now?
Where's the mill?
Well, it's at home where we left it, isn't it?
No, I mean on the model.
Oh, well, let's have a look. If that's the canal...
Yes.
...and that's the bridge...
Hmm?
...then it's just here, isn't it?
And what's this road doing here?
Don't know. Hang on. Model of the new road approved by the council last month. Work begins on the 24th. That's next week.
They can't build a road on top of our mill.
They can unless we do something about it. Come on.
Where are we going?
To object. That's it then.
So all we have to do is fill in these forms and bring them in tomorrow?
That's right. Come on, let's get to work. How are you doing?
Just finished. What do you think?
I said fill it in, not colour it in.
Yeah, but it'd look boring all done in the same colour.
If we don't fill these forms in correctly, they're going to pull our mill down. Here, I'll fill them in. Give me the form. Now, what does it say? The objector will here specify all sociological and environmental concerns regarding the building defined in the above-mentioned section and heretofore described as the development.
What's it mean?
Well, it's, Well, it means what it says. I'll answer the questions. You go and make some more tea. Now then, ask me another.
Paul, Paul. Here.
Oh, thanks. What time is it?
Tomorrow.
What?
It's time to take the forms back.
But I haven't finished, look.
I object to the new road because... Well, it's a start.
It's no good, it's too late. We're going to have to take our protest to the streets.
What can the streets do for us?
They can give us publicity. They can get the people on our side. Before we've finished, everyone in this town will know about us and our mill.
Are you sure that's a good idea?
Stop the new road!
Stop the new road!
Save our neighbourhood!
Save our neighbourhood!
Stop the new road!
Stop the new road!
Save our home!
Save our home!
Stop the new road!
Pull!
Save our neighbourhood!
Pull!
What?
Ah!
Sorry. what is it?
I don't think it's working.
I've got a better idea. Finished yet?
Yeah.
Good. Stop the need. What's that supposed to be?
No, it doesn't say stop the need. Look.
Oh, stop the new ra. Stop the new ra?
Well, I couldn't fit it all on one side, so I finished it off over here. Road.
Oh, right. Let's put it on the bike. Over here, look.
So what now?
Well, we drive through the town with that banner flying behind us.
Hey, that's a good idea.
Come on, then.
What?
Pedal.
Oh, right.
You're going to have to go faster than that.
It won't go any faster. I'm pedalling hard.
Go on, faster. I tell you what, I'll do the pedalling.
Okay.
Okay, stop here then.
That's it.
Now, you can go round the back and hold the banner. Okay.
Okay.
Go on then. You got it?
I've got it now. Are you ready?
Ready?
Ready.
Perfect. Good. Now make sure there's no traffic coming this time.
Okay. All clear.
Good.
Paul! Hang on. Hang on, Paul!
Daddy!
I think this needs repairing again. There we are, repaired again.
Good. Now, I can see you're getting very tired, Barry, so I've got something to help you.
That's very considerate.
It's in my nature. There you are. That'll help you keep up. Ready?
Ready!
That's on there. That's it.
Why do I need all this stuff, Paul?
For safety. Here, put that on.
But I felt safe before.
And I want you to stay that way. Take that.
So why do I need all this to stay safe?
Because we're going to do something that's going to get everybody in this town talking.
You mean I'm going to go out dressed like this?
Better than that. Come on. Follow me. So all you've got to do is climb to the top of the building, come down the outside, and I'll give out the leaflets at the bottom.
Hang on, hang on. I'm not climbing down the outside of that building.
Why not?
Because it's dangerous.
Well, you've got all the equipment.
Yeah, but I've never done any climbing.
You're not climbing.
Oh.
You're sliding down the outside.
Hey?
Well, you told me you'd had abseiling lessons.
No. Sailing lessons.
Oh. Well, in that case, perhaps you should start with a smaller building. Come on. How about this one?
Still too high.
Okay. This one?
No.
Ladies and gentlemen, gather round, gather round. Gather round to see a feat of such raw courage this town has never seen before. What in amazement, what in awe, what in terror has my colleague abseils down this garden wall.
Paul.
What?
Come here.
Hold those a minute, please. Okay. What is it?
Too high.
We'll try the next one, then. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen.
Paul.
Hold those a minute, please. What now?
Still too high.
We'll try the next one. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen!
Paul!
What now? I'll think of something else then. Thank you.
Paul! Paul! Are you sure this is a good idea, Paul?
Of course it is. We've tried everything else, this has got to work.
Hey! You just threw the key away.
Of course I have.
But now we're stuck.
Well, that's the idea. We're stuck here until somebody takes notice.
So what are we going to do in the meantime?
Well, I'm going to have a nice cup of tea. Hold that, will you?
Yeah.
Hold that.
Who's going to notice us?
Well, the town council will. That's why we're outside the town hall.
But it closed half an hour ago. Hey, we're lucky that man turned up to help, otherwise we could have been there all night.
Let's go home.
Hey, what's this?
It's been one of those leaflets the protesters gave us outside the town hall.
Oh, yeah. Help us save the rare spotted marsh wader. There's a picture of it here as well, look.
We haven't got time to mess about with things like that. We've got enough on our plate trying to save this place. Unless...
Unless what?
Unless we could prove to the council we've got a rare bird living near our mill. They'd have to cancel the road then.
I didn't know we'd got any spotted marsh waders living round here.
We've got better than that. We've got the rare spotted canalberry.
The what?
Right, here we are then.
Are you sure?
Yes, now don't speak, squawk. No, that's no good. I've got an idea.
Where are you going? Okay.
I've got it. To you then. There.
If you think I'm climbing that, you've got another thing coming.
Oh, you're not going to climb it.
Oh, good.
You're going to eat it.
Eat it?
Yeah, it's a canalberry's favourite food, his leaves, you know.
Yes, but it's not mine.
Would you prefer to eat worms?
Where's the leaves?
That's it. And here we see the spotted canalberry having a snack of his favourite food, leaves. And if we move in closer, we might even get a shot of his newly laid eggs.
His what?
Eggs.
Eggs?
Yeah. There we are, look.
Yeah, but they're still in the boxes.
Exactly. That's what makes a canalberry very special. He lays his eggs in boxes.
Oh, dear, oh, dear.
Right. Go on, then. Settle on them. And here we see the canalberry coming to hatch his newly laid eggs.
Sure this'll work, Paul?
Of course it'll work. This is a very expensive safety harness you've got here.
Oh, but why do I have to fly?
Because that's what birds do. And if people don't see you flying, they might think you're not real. Oh. Are you ready?
Not quite.
Go off.
I'm just getting settled. I'm just... Right. Whoa! Whoa!
Hey, that's
help.
Great, that.
Help!
Don't talk, squawk. Hey, it's brilliant. Hey, terrific, that. Just see how well the spotted canalberry blends in with his natural surroundings. And as we observe, the spotted canalberry is a very intelligent bird. He's doing the crossword. One of the spotted canalberry's favourite pastimes is to take a swim in the morning. Yes, it is. Hey, hey, it is. Come here. Hey, come back, Danny. Get back.
So So do you think we've done enough to convince them, then?
Of course we have. You mark my words. Any minute now, a letter will come through that letterbox downstairs telling us everything's OK. There you are. There it is now. Go fetch. This is it.
Who's it from, then?
The town hall. Oh, let's have a look. Dear Paul and Barry, blah, 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 blah. Yes, the area around the mill has been declared a special conservation zone and the new road has been cancelled. Yes, we've done it, Barry.
Hey, this is from the council as well.
Never mind about that. Help me with the bird table.
It says, Dear Paul and Barry, the area around your mill has been declared a special conservation zone.
Well, we know all about that. Come and help me with this bird table.
In view of this, your application to put up a bird table has been refused.
What?
Our heroes!
Do you know what?
Our
they're
heroes!
Absolutely fantastic.
Our heroes!
You can stop that.
Our
now.
Heroes!
Stop that. You look ridiculous.
You do look ridiculous!
What's happened to your moustaches? You've all grown. Obviously, that program, wait for it, grows on you.
Right. Okay, what we're going to do now, these are our bungalow heads. We award them bungalow points for if they do something good or bad, they can have them deducted as well. What they're going to do now to try and earn 10 bungalow points each is do a little tribute line to the Trucker Brothers. So we'll start off at the end with Hannah.
Hannah, if you start with your tribute to the Trucker Brothers, go.
They're so funny. I wish I was a boy so I could be a Chucker Brother too.
Pretty good five.
Five points.
I wish she was a boy. That's quite funny.
5 points.
There you go.
5 points to Serena.
They're as crazy as a hairy custard pie. So I wish I had real facial hair so I could grow a moustache just like theirs.
Very. No, I like that. Custard pies, they're funny. And you talked about going
mouldy. Okay, how many points?
10 points.
10 points.
10 points for Serena.
Okay, Luke, yours.
They're so hilarious.
No, Luke. No, we set Luke a challenge earlier for bungalow points to try and speak in the language of blah, 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 blah. And everything he says has to be blah, 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 blah. So Luke, you just spoke English then, and that is wrong, mate. So you don't get any bungalow points.
You get no. In fact, we're going to deduct 5 points from you. You got it wrong.
See you later, James.
The funniest guys with moustaches on TV.
Five points.
No, less than that. One.
No,
nothing.
No points for James.
Sorry, James.
Anu.
They're so funny, I think I need to go to loo. Oh.
Toilet humour, everyone.
We actually made a wee joke, everyone.
10 points.
Even though it was a wee joke, it was a big joke.
Yeah, all right. Damien.
They're the king of comedy. They're the kings of comedy after Dick and Dom.
Very good. Now, actually, second thoughts, that was very good because it was, you know, flattering us, but it could be a bit creepy. Seven boys, still pretty good.
Well done, we'll have a look at the leaderboard a little bit later, but right now, time to play this on the bungalow.
Sweet face, the sticky sweet race.
This is Sweet Face Challenge, an amazing game where basically you have to get sweets and stick them to your plate.
Let me have a go.
This is Richard. No, Dick cannot do it, it's a visual. But let's see if one of our bungalow guys can do it, one of our bungalow heads. The guy in the lead is James. He's in the lead. Oh, and Anu, you guys are head to head. So, right. Both of you are going to come and play. Yeah, is that all right?
Okay.
Both of you come up, take a stool
right,
each.
James,
you guys are going to
sit around
each other.
Right, they've got 30 seconds on the clock to try and stick as many sweets as they can as possible to their face. Okay. If they win, they get 20 bungalow points. So come on, 30 seconds on the clock.
Now, not yet. First of all, to make it a little bit easier, rip those sashes off. Wait. Put it back on. We're going to give you 5 bungalow points if you do the best rip, okay? 5, go.
Oh!
That looked like that. I think that Anu, you nearly said a very naughty word though, so I'm not going to give you any. But we'll give you 5 each. That was pretty good.
5 more. The points are being thrown away this morning, aren't they? Okay, 30 seconds on the clock. Sticky Sweet Face Challenge. Let's go, guys.
Go.
Stick it to your face. Come on, James.
Come on, here he goes. Come on. Let's have a look
at James first. Okay, James, stay still. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 on James's face.
Right, Anu, what have you done there? 1, 2, buckle my shoe, there we go. And that's it, you got 2, that's pretty good though.
So that means James gets 20 bungalow points, and he's now in the lead here on Dick and Dom in the bungalow. Nice one, mate.
But right now, a word from our sponsors.
Dick and Dom are rubbish and I like Angelica better.
Well, there we go. That was a very nice message. Thank you very much. We know where you live, by the way.
Now, the other day, there's an attic right up here in the Dick and Dom bungalow, right? And what we did was we went in there, looked at some of the old videotapes that were there, and we found... Yes, we found one videotape called Rent-A-Ghost.
Rent-A-Ghost. Hey? No, it's an absolutely wicked program. You've got to stick with it. We're going to show you the program in 2 halves. But before we do that, we're going to go over to these guys and offer them more bungalow points.
Yes,
okay?
Yes. Now then,
turn around.
Now then, Luke, you've already not got those bungalow points you could have got for doing the blah, blah, blah language. So sorry, mate. So now, let's give it to Hannah, this challenge. Hannah on the end there. Your challenge now is to go over to Grandad Dick's face, remove his face, and put your head through there and stand for 15 minutes. So do you want to run through? I'll take it through.
Okay, you go do
come
that.
Come with me, come with me, Hannah. This way. Right, come on here.
There we go.
Here we go.
Do you think she'll be able to do it?
Right, up you go. Put your head through there.
What do you think? She'll look stupid.
Right, there she is. It's now Grandad Hannah.
So stay there. Lovely beard, by the way. It really does suit you. And now what we're going to do is settle down and watch a program. You fancy watching this program called Rent-A-Ghost, yeah?
Yeah.
Seriously, it's one of the best programs you will ever watch.
You're going to love it. And remember, sing along with the theme tune at home if you know. I know there's all those students out there watching.
Students.
Come on. Here we go.
Rent-A-Ghost.
If your mansion house needs haunting, just call Rent-A-Ghost. We've got spooks and ghouls and freaks and fools at Rent-A-Ghost. Hear the phantom of the opera sing a haunting melody. Remember, what you see is not a mystery, but Rent-A-Ghost.
Ethel, there'll be plenty of time to sweep the carpet when we've reached the new house. Why don't you just relax and enjoy the journey?
Because it's vulgar and undignified. Just because we bought a whole lot of new furniture, there was no need to tell Rent-A-Ghost to transport it by air convoy, you big show-off.
There's no need to be so house-proud, Ethel.
I'm not being house-proud, I'm being cloud-proud. Other wives have to worry about getting moths in their carpet, I have to worry about getting birds in mine. And how do you know we won't lose our way and get mixed up with all the air traffic?
Fret not, friends! Hazel the Mac Witch has placed signposts all along the route.
Well, where is that other spook, Miss Novak?
She went to Holland and is still trying to sneeze her way out of the tulip fields. But fear not, she is sending her cousin as a replacement.
Well, where is she, then?
I am here. I am Nadia Popov.
Greetings, Miss Popov. I am Timothy Claypole.
Hello.
Yeah, Mr.
Oh, Master and Mr. Speaker, and Dobbin the horse.
How do you do? So you are Miss Novak's cousin?
Oh, yes. When I was alive, I helped Tamara in her flower shop, and so now I have agreed to do her this flavor. But of course, if you do not want me to stay, I can make myself uncommon.
No, you can join Rent-A-Ghost on approval.
Oh, good. To fly like this is a privilege. This sort of travel is not available to the major public.
General public.
Oh, General Field Marshal, who cares what rank he is? Oh, Mr. Claypole, darling, are you expecting rain?
No. Seagulls.
Come on, you spooks. Concentrate on getting us to the new house. Which is supposed to be the convoy escort? Where is she?
Oh, she went ahead to the next cross clouds to make sure we have a clear route.
Oh, this is a busy cross clouds.
Aye, and here comes the furniture convoy.
And this holds up the other traffic.
Good grief, she stopped an airliner in mid-flight.
I fear that is not all she has done.
What is wrong, Mr. Claypole? Have you spotted a seagull? Oh, or has a seagull spotted you?
It seems the power of that witch Hazel's magic has affected the atmosphere. Huge black thunderclouds are forming overhead.
Just sit there, you stupid sprite. Either stop the rain or transport us down immediately.
Alas, I have run out of psychic energy, and the witch Hazel has flown away to take cover. I am afraid we must continue our journey in the deluge.
Oh.
ready to go, Mr. Painting.
Yes, the van's picked up the furniture, so I'll be leaving as soon as the new owners arrive. I thought I'd just pop in and say goodbye, Mrs. Perkins.
Oh, we shall miss having you next door, so I suppose it's more convenient living next to the store. How did you manage to sell your old house so quickly?
Well, they were looking for a bigger house, and as soon as I told them about mine, they jumped at it. They'll be here any minute. They're coming by air.
Oh, British Airways.
No, Persian carpet.
Oh, very funny. Are they coming from overseas?
No, South Ealing. That's dreadful weather for flying. They'll be soaked to the skin. Well, I expect you're looking forward to seeing them again.
Seeing who again?
Oh, I forgot to mention it. Your new neighbours are the old neighbours. The Meekers.
Oh, no. Oh.
Good heavens. Mr. Perkins! Mr. Perkins! I don't understand. I was just telling your wife a piece of news and she suddenly fainted.
Dear. Well, I'm afraid poor Rose is very highly strung. Oh. It's strange, isn't it, the different ways in which people react to news. The slightest little worry seemed to upset her, but you could tell me that we were being invaded by man-eating monsters from outer space. I wouldn't bat an eyelid.
Well, I only mentioned the Meekers are moving in next door.
Ah, it's about time you showed up. All the trouble you've caused. The furniture drifted away in the storm. I got soaking wet, and Ethel and a horse are drifting up there in an armchair.
Well, at least the chair bore.
Very funny.
Don't worry. The wind's blowing them in this direction. Look, yon's a Perkins house, and you're next to it. Now, after I've transported you down, I'll away and round up the rest of the furniture. Transport the carpet.
Oh, I'm here. You wasn't. Ethel!
The Meekers' house.
Miss Popham, there must be an explanation as to why we both have run out of psychic energy.
I suspect it may be due to the rainwater covering our feet.
I have come to the same confusion, darling. The water is causing a short circuit to our psychic energy, so empty the water, our psychic energy will return, and we can switch on the sultana.
Current. Pull out the plug, Miss Popov.
Nice.
Goodbye, Mr. Painting. Thank you for bringing us the bad news.
I've heard of local showers, but this is ridiculous.
Oh, dear.
Yes?
Could I borrow a towel, please? I don't know what's happened. It seems to have been down there rather bad.
Good. But our psychic energy may not be fully restored, so let us play safe by transporting down together. After all, two noses are better than one.
I think we make a poo-poo, Mr. Kleinpole.
Miss Popov, we must transport separately.
Yes. What? Wait! I am Popov.
And I, Claypole. Gatsooks!
Quick! Reverse! Mr. Claypole, I exhume.
Greetings, Miss Popov.
We must transport separately, but at the same time. Synchronize your noses. One, two, three. I think we make another boo-boop, Mr. Claypole.
Here, that's Ethel. Ethel? Ethel, where are you? Ethel?
Harold! I think we've landed on top of a chimney, Dobbin. Oh, for heaven's sake, don't move.
I don't understand why you're so upset about the Meekers moving next door. They seem very nice
you
people on the
side. Painting, here's your shirt beautifully ironed.
Oh, thank you.
Arthur, the chimney's on fire.
My shirt! Be careful, my shirt. Oh!
Ethel, where are you?
I'm up here, Harold. I can't move.
Ring the fire brigade! Turn the chimney
on fire! Nine, nine, nine! Oh, Mr. Meeker!
There,
Yes, no need to ring the fire brigade. It's not a fire. There's a chair on the chimney.
Oh, extraordinary. I'll get a polo. We can push it off the top here.
No. My wife is sitting on the chair.
Oh. Your wife is on a chair on the chimney?
Yes.
Why doesn't she get off the chair?
Well, she's afraid the horse might fall off her lap.
Horse?
Yes, darling.
Oh, stop it! What? Stop it! Stop it! Stop it! I don't want to hear anymore. Why did you have to follow us here? We came here to start a new life, and we were happy for a while. I even began to stop twitching. And now this has come up. I'm not going to stand for it anymore. I'm going to inform the authorities.
But tell your wife to go and squat in her own chimney.
Now look what you've done, you bully.
Very well.
Now, Mr. Claypool,
I have just received a spirit message from the Mac Witch. She has rounded up the furniture in the sky and will now transport it here by remote control. One item at a time.
Mr.
And there is the first item.
Mr. Prentin, this is our new spook, Miss Popoff.
Oh, are you?
Mr. Claypool, now Ethel and Dobbin are on the Perkins chimney. I want you to transport them here immediately.
I can't stand any more of this. I hope, first of all, I'm made to fly through a thunderstorm with a demented pantomime horse on my lap. Sitting on top of a chimney like a smoked haddock, and now I'm being bombarded with furniture.
I can't help it.
Why did you summon me? I haven't finished my work.
You silly witch! Your work is causing chaos. You are transporting the furniture willy-nilly.
Oh, never mind willy-nilly, whoever he is. They have no sympathy for Mrs. Mickershire's sopset, and all they do is stand arguing about blancmanges.
Trifles!
Poor Mrs. Mickers had a very hard and tiring day. She needs a good night's sleep.
What the terrible ordeal I've been through. I doubt I'll sleep a wink tonight. Or if I do, I'll have nightmares.
No, you won't.
Oh, yes, I will.
Silence! No need for commotion. I'll prove my devotion by skillfully mixing a magic dream potion.
A magic dream potion? You're better with lotion. Egad, what a stupid and dangerous notion.
Oh, very good, Mr. Claypool.
Let me get this straight. Am I to understand you can make a magic potion for any kind of dream?
Aye, any kind. Do you want to buy one?
No, but I'd like to hire Rent-A-Ghost for my department store. I've got a wonderful idea for a new sales gimmick.
Oh! Hey,
ladies and gentlemen, with every bed we're selling, we're giving away a free dream potion. Each dream potion contains an exciting story.
This one is entitled Hurricane, an egg certificate dream. Hurricane will blow your mind.
And here is this week's special offer, a nightly serial dream in 6 gripping episodes.
With our dream potions, you have no need to travel. Simply stay in bed and let your mind wander.
We do hope you have enjoyed flying aboard this British Airways Concorde today.
And for those of you interested in buying a children's bed, we're making a children's dream. Miss Popoff will tell the story, and Hazel the Witch will mix the ingredients.
A beautiful princess is sitting in the garden, looking at the little green caterpillars and pretty yellow flutterbys. Also in the garden is a frog, but she does not see it because the frog is congealed in the bushes. Then the frog jumps out and he says, "If you kiss me, I will turn into a prince." But she says, "Do you think I am a stupid to believe such a hen and cow story?"
Cock and bull story.
Oh, sorry. So then he says, "This is a matter of life and death. If you do not kiss me, I will croak." So she kisses him, and he turns into a prince, and they fall in love, and their eyes are filled with sediment, and their hearts are full of emulsion.
I say, Miss Popoff's popped off. Don't tell me you're allergic to flowers like your cousin.
Our whole family is allergic.
Mr. Claypool, I want to...
to Clay Hall.
Why were you looking in the mirror with your eyes closed?
I wanted to see what I look like when I'm asleep. But can I help you, Mr. Speaker?
Yes, I want another of Witch's Dream poses to take tonight. Oh, I enjoyed the dream I had last night.
This is...
I don't tell me what it is. I want it to be a surprise.
Very well. How is Master Meeker today?
Now, that brings me to the second thing I want. My husband sneaked out of the house this morning with his golf clubs. Well, I thought he was having breakfast. He knows perfectly well I need his help to put up the curtains in the new house.
So?
So I want you to transport that lazy blighter back to the house right now.
You'd better watch.
Arthur! Oh, good heavens! Mika's standing on the dining room table playing golf with hard-boiled eggs.
I never heard him shout four.
I warned him. I wouldn't put up with any more of this behavior. Arthur, ring the police. Let them see for themselves what a fruitcake we have for a neighbor.
As you can see, they're beautiful.
Be continued.
Do you like a bit of Rent to Ghost, guys?
Yeah.
That's good. Yes. Pretty cool program, eh? And we're going to be playing a game all about Rent to Ghost just in a shake of a lamb's tail. All right, then, here we go. An email here from Rachel Nottingham. We'll give you the email address in a minute, all right? Just to say, your program is wicked, and you both make me laugh. I think you must be talking about the twins here.
Yeah.
And it says, oh, yeah, and Dick, I like Dom's shirt. She likes it a lot.
All right, guys. Bungalow heads, what do you think of the dumb shirt?
Nice?
Yeah.
Good. You know, you get all two extra bungalow points.
In between reactions there. Right, these are the bungalow heads. They stay with us Saturday and Sunday morning on the bungalow. They actually sleep inside the bungalow tonight.
It's a bungalow.
Thank you, bungalow. And if they do something good, we award them points. If they do something bad, we deduct points. The challenge to Hannah earlier was to put her head for 15 minutes during Rent-A-Ghost through Grandad Dick's portrait. And she did it, so that means 15 points to you, Hannah.
Hey, Hannah, come back around.
You can take your tash off now.
I'll tell you what, let's have a look to see who's in the lead for the big prize at the end of Sunday's show. Let's have a look at the leaderboard so far.
Anu has 20 points.
Serena's got 10 points.
James has 40s in the lead.
Next up, we've got Luke with no points.
Luke. Come on, Luke. Damien's got 12.
And Hannah has got 20.
So, now, we're going to play another game where you could grab some points back. It's all to do with Rent-A-Ghost. It's called Bungalow Bogeyman. Dom will explain how you can play.
Okay, basically, we need two of you guys to play Bungalow Bogeyman. This is so cool. I bet you wish you guys were in the bungalow. All right, we basically need two of you guys to pull the most ugly, scary faces. The most ugly, scary faces will play the game. So,
get in the line,
Right. When I say now, strike your scary face pose, okay?
Right, okay. Ready?
You ready?
One, two, three. Now!
Strike your pose.
Hannah!
There we go.
Damien! Luke! Anna! Serena!
James!
Right, I've picked one, Dom. Have you picked one?
I picked one as well. I think Anu was pretty disgusting, that one. That was like...
Well, I'm actually going, not just because he's not got no bungalow points, but I'm going for Luke here, because look at that. Do it again, Luke. Let's have a look. The red bits under his eyes. Right, so you guys, Anu, Luke, come on over and let's play this game.
You'd better watch out, they're a gruesome crew. Get them first or they'll get you.
They're the Bungalow Bogeyman.
Rent-A-Ghost Bungalow Bogeyman. And here is the Bungalow Bogeyman. We have all the characters from Rent-A-Ghost. Look, Timothy Claypole.
Mrs. Popoff.
McWitch.
And also, making a surprise appearance at the back, we have Dobbin the horse.
Now, you guys have got two buckets of balls. And what happens is when you throw these, they actually Velcro. They stick onto the characters. So you've got to stick as many as you can. We'll show you.
Ready?
We'll just one on each. Ready? Oh, it didn't work.
Rubbish. Absolutely rubbish.
I'll show you. Here you go. When it hits, it sticks.
You see? Oh, I like that. Could be a catchphrase.
It hits, it sticks. You know what I mean?
You like that? We'll put that in the script tomorrow. Okay, so basically, if you hit Dobbin as well, you get a bonus 5 points.
And if you win the game, you get 25 points. So, Luke, you really need to try and catch up here. So, come on, mate. Get in your positions.
Ready?
Get your buckets. There you go, Anu. There you go, Luke. Ready? Okay, ready. We need some time on the clock, please.
Are you ready?
They have 60 seconds, 1 minute to complete this challenge. Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Go!
Go! Bungalow Bogeyman!
Come on, guys.
Softer. Run softer. Little stick.
Softer.
Try underarm.
Which? Oh, come on.
Try underarm.
Oh, I think that one did stick. just fell off again. Go
on. Wrong. Go on.
Well, no, close. Oh,
try and get. Come on, Timothy Claypole's up at the back here.
We've done well so far. Oh, look, there's two on there, on McWitch.
Come on, right.
McWitch has now got two balls.
Try the top.
Oh, yes, we've got one hanging off her ear.
Softer, that's it. How many seconds have we got left? 34 seconds left.
Well done, guys. Keep going.
Right, McWitch, McWitch, yes, you've got one. Go on, 29 seconds.
Go on, get, go on.
Where's Dobbin? Hello, Dobbin, where are you, Dobbin?
Dobbin. Dobbin, you stupid horse.
Come on, there he is,
quick,
yes. Go on, five extra for you. Yes.
Go on, right, Dobbin's going, Dobbin's going. Oh,
yes.
Gone.
How on earth are we going to total all this up?
Oh, yes, you've got Mrs. Pop-Pop. She's a popular favourite.
Oh, no, man. Okay, five, four, three, two, one. Thank you so much. That was Bungalow, Bogey Men. Okay, let's count the scores.
Let's have a count.
Do you want to go first with Anu?
Okay, Anu.
The white ball.
White. Okay, there we go. We've got one. We got two.
Two.
Three.
We got three.
Four. Five, six. And we got one on Dobbin.
Two on Dobbin.
So six, seven, eight.
Eight, right.
Eight in total.
That means
there's nine, one on his foot. Nine.
Okay.
Nine.
One, I knew, nine. And for Luke, one, two, three, four, five, six. Let's have a look around the back.
Seven, eight, nine, ten.
11 balls to Luke.
Come on, man.
Luke is the winner. 25 points. But remember, if you hit Dobbin, you got five extra.
But it's only the first person to hit Dobbin. So that was Anu. So Anu gets five. You get 25, Luke. Well done.
Well done. That was Bungalow Bogeyman.
Oh,
more of
rhubarb.
That next week.
Rhubarb.
Dick and Dobbin to Bungalow.
Rhubarb. Oi. What did you say when you meet a ghost? How do you boo?
I think Dick and Dom are a load of rubbish.
Okay,
sorry, we weren't discussing what's happening next, really. We were just like, what are we doing? But we know what we're doing.
What about those anti-vox pops? They're bad, aren't they? They hate us out there.
Here's what's coming up later on Dick and Dom in Dad Bungalow.
It's the CBBC Channel live on a Saturday morning. It's wrong. That's wrong. We've already had Chuckovision, haven't we? You've seen it already. We'd like to see more. You can see more of that.
Ubot is coming up next. You can also see part two of Rentgoes. We've got the menu right now.
We have the menu. Let's do it poshly now. Here we go. This is what's still to come on Dick and Dom into Bungalow. We've got the magic of Ubot in just a second. Stay tuned for that.
And straight after that, you can see, there we are, part two of Rentgoes. Fantastic. Glimmer Claypole and Flaming Dragon.
And also on Dick and Dom into Bungalow, there is more Chuckovision for you. So that's good news. Look at them. Brilliant. Our heroes, yes. The Chucker Brothers a little bit later.
Fantastic. So there we go. And should we watch another programme?
Yeah,
okay. Guys, take seats. Sit down amongst the
right. Next on the Bungalow, it is Ubot. So Dom.
But before we watch it,
Dom's got a little tricky trick for you.
A quick magic trick to go to a magic programme. Here we go. Here we go. Magic. A little piece of moon rock. What's the moon made out of? I'll tell you. Cheese.
Give him a round of applause, everyone. Come on, what about that?
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Everyone want to watch Ubot? Yeah, you want to watch Ubot?
Yeah.
I have it here. It's going in the machine. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ubot.
What do you think, guys? Guys? There. Where are they all?
They just popped down to get some food for the moose's
head. They've gone where? They've popped down the road to get some food for the moose's head. Yep. All right, fair enough. All right, I'll tell you what. Because we just watch a magic type programme, Ubot, yeah? Do you fancy learning a magic trick?
Right.
Fancy doing a bit of Dom's tricky training? All right then, good. Well, come over here and take a few by the breakfast bar, because I'm going to show you a magic trick, all right? And then you've got to learn how to do it. Now, here's the deal. You're going to show it to all your mates later when they come back from getting the moose head food, all right? And if they can't work out how it's done, you earn an extra 20 bungalow points. And that will put you really high in the lead on bungalow points, and you could get that star prize, yeah, which is that beautiful TV. All right then. Okay then, here's the trick that you've got to try and show your mates, all right? Have a look. See the ring there? It's on this finger, and it's going to try and jump to this finger. You ready? Watch this. Ready? One, two, three. And it's jumped, you see? And watch it jump back. Buying, and it's jumped back again. Buying, buying. Now, tell me something. Do you know how it's done?
I think so.
You think so?
Yeah.
All right, then. Okay, then. Right, well, how do you think it's done?
You swap fingers, so you have those two, and then those two.
Hopefully your mates won't work it out as quickly as you just did.
Right.
I'll show you it now. What I'm going to do is I'm going to demonstrate it for all you guys at home. You can do it straight away. Find the ring and do it. All right, look at it. Here it goes. I start like this. Okay, can you see? There you go. One, two. I switch my fingers when they're in the air and bring them down again. But it looks like it jumps like that. You see that? Isn't that cool? All right, now, if they do guess how the trick's done, you get catapulted into space. And we won't see you again. Does that sound cool?
No.
Right, tough. There you go, there's the ring. I want you to practice.
Okay.
Put it down, do it down here so the camera can see. Ready? Start on there. Ready, here we go. Serena, on three. One, two, three. Oh, hey, hey, that was interesting. I'll tell you what, well, you've got 20 minutes to rehearse it, get it looking pretty good, yeah? And don't forget, you can win 20 bungalow points if they don't guess, all right?
Okay.
Get practicing. All right, now, earlier on, we asked you guys to phone in if you had any problems with Dick and Dom. We can actually help solve your problems, and hopefully the phone should be ringing now. Oh, look at that. It's ringing, look at it, violently ringing. Hello?
Hi.
Who's that?
It's Willie.
Willie what?
No, not Willie what. Willie Wowie.
What? Willie Wonty?
No, not what Willie Wowie. Just Willie Wowie, all right?
So your name is not what Willie Wonty, just Willie Wonty. Okay, all right then. And what's your problem? Hello? Oh, he's gone. All right. Next caller. Who's the next caller?
Hello.
Oh, hello. Who's that?
This is Richard Stewart, Peter III, St. John Smythe, Susan.
All right then. And what's your problem?
Well, I have this really bad problem where I sometimes tend to ignore people.
You ignore people? And what kind of people do you ignore? What kind of people do you ignore? Hello? Who do you ignore?
Yes, I'm still here.
Who do you ignore? Who do you like ignoring? Hello? Stop ignoring me! Hello? What a joker. There we go. Hey, listen, if you've got any problems, Thank you very much. All you have to do is give us a phone call right here in the bungalow. If you have got any problems, all you have to do is phone us. We'll give you the number later on, all right? Okay, we'll give you the number later on. Hello, guys. Look, come over here. Dick should be joining us in a minute, and you guys are going to be doing the pants dance, which is absolutely fantastic. Oh, here he comes.
Hello.
Hello there. Now, watch. Should we delve in and...
Well, tell you what we'll do first. Since we've totted up some of the scores recently, we're going to have a look at the bungalow scoreboard. Let's have a look. See you. Yes. See who's in the lead. See who's losing at the moment here in Dick and Dom and the Bungalow. Let's have a look now.
Bungalow.
Thank you, Bungalow.
All right.
Anna is on 22.
Serena is on 12.
James is still in the lead. Go on, James.
Go on, James.
42 points.
And next up, we've got Luke with 2.
Oh, come on, Luke.
Come on, Luke.
Damien's got 14. That is his second to last.
And Hannah has got 22.
Now, Damien, because you're second to last at the moment, now you have to try and join in with us with the Dick and Dom pants dance.
Okay, so we're going to demonstrate the pants dance first of all.
Yes.
You ready?
We'll get our pants. Hold on.
Okay. That's a good magic trick. Remember this one?
You've got stripy ones.
Here we go. Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready. Okay.
Now, here is the pants.
This is what you do. You put your pants on the head. You can all do this at home when you've got a nice clean pair of pants.
There you go.
Put your pants on your head. You change the lighting in the studio to make it disco-y, and then you sing along to this song. Here we go.
Much. Well, that was that. Okay.
Easy as that. That is the bungalow pants dance. So, Damien.
Damien.
We need a clean pair of pants for Damien. I've got one in my back pocket here.
There you
Damien,
go. Damien, up. Come on.
Take your position. Remember, you could win. How many bungalow points is he going to get for this?
25
bungalow points if you get this right. So, pants on your head.
Did you hear me? He says, I deserve more.
Look at it. Seriously, pants on my head.
Yeah, you look beautiful, man.
Just shut up and put the pants on your head. Right, here we go. Okay, hit that music, the disco lights, please. Do the dance, come.
Go on, do it.
Yeah. Go on, baby. You got those sweaty pants on your head, Damien.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Sing along at home. Come on, there's the words at the bottom of the screen. Yeah. Friends.
Everybody, Damien!
What do you think, bungalow heads? Do you reckon we should give him the 25 points for that?
25.
He doesn't
want
me to win the team,
no,
do you?
Of course he doesn't want you to win. He wants to win the team. All right, girls, break it up. Go sit down there. Let's go sit down there. We'll give them to him.
25 points to Damien. Nice one, Damien. Now, on Dick and Dom in the Bungalow, it's time for the second part of Rent-A-Go. So let's get it into the machine. and check out what Miss Popoff, McWitch and Mr. Claypole are up to. Here they are.
There we are, here we are.
As you can see, they're beautifully sprung for all occasions. They're absolutely marvellous. Can't tell the sign.
I'm much obliged, Mr. Claypole. Oh, no. He must have just woken up and transported himself to find me. Ever since he drank that magic potion yesterday, he's been hooked on dreaming. He transported himself into Harold's pajamas and all he wants to do is sleep. Dobbin! Dobbin! Dobbin!
Dobbin!
This stupid beast has drunk three different dream potions. Just look at it. He's having a nightmare. He's sleepwalking. Go, quick, one of you spooks. Transport yourself. Transport yourself.
Mrs. Beaton, you're causing a disturbance in the shop, and please stay there. See to the horse, doctor. Please be quiet.
Now, finally, ladies and gentlemen, if you buy more than one bed, we are giving away a dream potion specially made by Hazelwood Witch called the Family Dream. Oh, yes, the Family Group Dream. What better way to achieve togetherness than to share your dream with your children? The Red Ghost team will now demonstrate. Would you mind moving back? Thank you very much. Here is the potion with sterilized straws. Thank you. That's it. Splendid. To the beds, please. Right.
Let's all go to the fun fair.
Oh, what a good idea.
Off we go, laughing and shouting. And here we are, getting on the Big Dipper. Up we go, whee! Down we go, whoa! Around we go, ah! Isn't this fun? Woo!
Asleep. He's got a long neck and a face like a horse.
Oh, yes. And what do you want of my husband?
Desk constable said your husband sounded very agitated on the phone, Mrs. Perkins, so I thought I'd deal with this one myself. I understand it's about your next door neighbour.
Yes, well, I hardly like to tell you.
Oh! Harold! A policeman just arrived at the Perkins house. They're going to complain about our behaviour just like they threatened. We could be prosecuted for causing a breach of
peace. Peace be with you, Mr. Smeeker. Your reticule and your dream potion, you left them at the store.
That's the least of our worries. Now listen carefully, Mr. Claypole. There's a policeman next door, and I want you to make sure he doesn't understand a single thing that the Perkins tell him.
I am rather busy, madam, so if you could...
Very well. I hate to say this, Sergeant, but the people next door are as mad as March hares, and when my husband tells you what they've been up to, you'll understand. Arthur, tell him.
In
nostri vicini di casa ci fanno impazzire. Vogliamo reclamare. Non so perché sto parlando così. Deve essere che cosa che ho mangiato.
I don't know what you're talking about. Why can't you speak English?
Look, Arthur, I know we went to Venice for our holiday, but there's no need to show off. I'll tell him. Unsere Nachbarn machen uns verrückt. Ich wüsste nun feine und fixiere. Nick, wo sie darüber sprechen, ja, ist ein Oft in der Luft legen.
When you're ready to speak plain English, I should be ready to listen. And in the meantime, I should be considering whether to report you for wasting a police officer's time.
Warum unsprechen italienisch mit der
Momento.
Oh, now stop worrying, Ethel. Mr. Claypole has cast another spell. The Perkins and the policeman are going to forget the whole incident.
It's the horse I'm worried about. He doesn't respond when the spooks try to summon him, and he's still out there sleepwalking. Alone. He could be mugged or snapped.
Oh, don't be ridiculous, Ethel. Now, I'm going to lock up. Now, you make sure you take your dream potion or you'll be up all night worrying. Yeah. Good night, sweetheart. Good night,
Oh, where is the lotion I left under the counter this morning?
Oh, I gave that to Mistress Meeker.
But that was a nightmare potion made specially for folk who like ex-certificate horror dreams. It'll scare her out of her wits. Miss Popoff, why couldn't you stop this stupid sprite?
How should I know what other people do? I'm not my brother's keeper.
Quickly, transport yourself to her. You might just be in time to wake her up before she starts dreaming.
I hope McWitch's potion gives me a nice, interesting dream. Oh, drat, I'm supposed to take it in, but...
Kind of dream. Oh, it's the old finding yourself on the street in your nightclothes one. I'd have thought which could have been a bit more original. I wonder if this is one of those dreams where you can fly. I love that sort.
Rose!
Mrs. Meeker! Oh, how boring. I was hoping I'd meet someone interesting like Burt Reynolds.
You should be ashamed standing there in the street in your nightclothes.
Don't talk to me like that, Mr. Perkins. If I hadn't taken that potion, you wouldn't be here. I've always wanted to do that to someone like you.
Oh, really?
I think I'll have another try at flying.
Kindly go away from our house.
Perhaps I could do it like McWitch does it. Oh, Mrs. Perkins, could I borrow a broom?
No, you certainly can't.
Get her one. Anything to get rid of her.
Well, all locked up. Ethel. Ethel. Sweetheart.
Go home and do your sweeping.
I'm not going to sweep with it. I'm going to fly it.
Oh, this is outrageous! Will you please not keep on disturbing our peace? First thing in the morning, we'll report this to the police.
I thought McWitch would have given me a bit of spooky magic to do in this dream. Summoning. That's it. I'll try to summon Harold.
Ethel Meeker!
Oh, it...
What do you think you're doing now? Go inside.
This is my dream, not yours.
Ethel Meeker, will you come running about in your nightdress?
Oh, thank heavens. Peace at last.
I'm so sorry.
sorry about the boo-boo last night.
Well, so you should be. If the Perkins report Ethel's behaviour to the police, they could charge her with disturbing the peace.
Oh, but the Perkins can complain to the police if they're asleep.
What do you mean, if they're asleep?
All we have to do is give them a wee spray of this dream potion before the policeman arrives. So it's all okay. Let's go.
He's here already. He's out there ringing their doorbell.
Fear not, there is still time.
Hope he's right. What kind of dream potion is he going to spray on them anyway?
Oh, I should have thought that would be obvious. Since there are two of the Perkins, there is only one potion that can be used. The family group dream.
Thank you for coming so promptly, Sergeant.
That's all right, Mr. Perkins. I had to come back for my hat. Now, what seems to be the trouble?
Well, I'm afraid you'll find what we're going to tell you rather hard to believe.
I doubt it, sir. You just say what you want to say in your own words.
Let's all go to the fun fair.
Oh, what a good idea.
Off we go, laughing and shouting. And here we are, getting on the Big Dipper. Up we go, whee! Down we go, oh! Around we go, ah! Isn't it fun? Ooh!
More Rent Goes tomorrow on Dick and Dom in the Bungalow in its entirety, so make sure you tune in then between 9 and 12.
It is a wicked show, Rent a Ghost. We want to know what you guys think of it. Why don't you email us? It's bungalow@bbc.co.uk.
That's bungalow. Thank you, Bungalow.
Thank you, Bungalow.
bbc.co.uk.
We want to know what you think of Rent a Ghost. We think it's wicked. Do you like Rent a Ghost?
Hey, down, listen. Hold on. Have you enjoyed your morning so far with us?
Want to come in and join us here in the Bungalow, don't you? Such a great place. Hey, listen, before Rent a Ghost, we set Serena a special tricky challenge. Yeah, it was Dom's tricky challenge, and she had to learn a trick, and now she's got to perform it for you guys. Okay, you ready to see some magic?
Yeah.
Okay, now let's get her through the bearded curtain.
Now, if the guys guess how Serena did the trick, then she gets catapulted to space, doesn't she, Dom?
Okay, there you
go. But if they
don't,
they get 10 points each. And if they don't guess how Serena got the trick right, then Serena gets 25 bungalow points.
There we go. Okay. Are you guys ready? Okay,
yes.
Here we go. This is Serena, the amazing magician. Can you all see that, yeah? Okay, okay, there we go. The ring is here. Watch it very carefully. Here we go, Serena, go for it. One, two, three,
Hooray.
And it's jumped. Did you see that? Did you see it jump fingers?
Yeah.
Okay, now we're not gonna do it again. It actually jumped, take the ring off. Let's take
right.
the ring off.
Okay,
ring off.
Let's get someone's reaction. James, how was that done?
I have no clue.
Okay, Luke?
Hannah?
Yes. Anu?
Yes.
Did it when she fill it down? Was the ring open on the
side? No. So it's down to Damien. Down to Damien.
Damien, get it wrong. Get it wrong.
How do you think it was done?
Come on, Damien.
The ring jumped from one finger to another. How was it done?
Magic.
It jumped.
Come on. He hasn't got it.
When she was doing the thing, but when the last one, I think she like.
No, 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 no. You're not allowed to help.
Shut up.
I think she put like it's like there's a. Opening at the bottom.
No! Serena!
Win!
You did it, well done. That means you get 25 bungalow points. You don't get catapulted in space. You guys get naughty bungalow
nothing.
Points.
Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Waffle,
No, you can't do magic. I've been training in that army years. You can't just pick up any old black and white magic wand and pretend to do magic. Piff, puff, puff!
Mate, did you hear something coming out of that cupboard?
Mice in the cupboard, that's
mice
all it is. Yeah,
mice
there we go.
In the cupboard. Now, on Dick and Dom in the Bungalow, it's time for this.
Come on!
Roll up, it's time to meet the strangely talented, they're unique.
And look at the prize that the strangely talented contestants could win today. Yes, it's the mounted fruitcake.
Beg your pardon?
Mounted fruitcake.
I'll go take it over there.
Okay. Now, basically, in Strangely Talented, each week we have three very strangely talented people who are going to show us...
Yes.
They're going to show us their strange talents. And the bungalow... And the bungalow heads over there are going to give them scores to decide who they think is the most strangely talented person. So let's go over here. Behind the curtain, we have our first strangely talented guest. It is Sadie. She's 67 years old. Yes, 67 years old. The tap dancing granny. Here she is. Okay, Sadie, give her a round of applause, guys.
Yay! Right there.
Sadie. Right, Sadie,
turn
you
around.
Come back a little bit. Just over here. That's it. Okay.
Turn around.
Turn around. Okay, you ready? And after three, you do your tap dancing. 3, 2, 1, go!
Let's
all go dance. It's a tap dancing granny, everyone!
Let's
Sadie, 67 years old, the tap dancing granny. Thank you so much. Write your scores down, guys.
Okay.
Yes. The bungalow heads are going to decide who the winner of the mounted fruitcake is. The second contestant on Strangely Talent here in Dick and Dom in the Bungalow. A round of applause, bungalow heads. It's Sam Taylor and Benjamin Isbell, the unicyclist, 8 and 23. Hello, guys. Come in. Take your stadium in the middle. Okay, and you come over here. Right, are you ready? Okay, after three. Oh, 1, 2, 3.
Go.
Off you go, and the music, please. Here they go.
Where's he gone?
He's gone.
He's
legged
it.
What's he
doing?
He's coming through.
Oi, he's coming back. Oi.
Hello, sailor.
Oi.
Hello. Strangely talented. Look at that.
Brilliant.
Come on, guys, what do you think about this? This is good, isn't it? This is good, this. This is good. Come on, clap along. Yeah.
Right. Woo!
The unicyclist here in the Dick and Dom Bungalow. This is good, guys, don't you reckon? Hey, they're scoring this now. The bungalow heads are scoring Sam and Benji for this task.
Oh, there's a slight fall there. The points could be deducted for that.
Yeah, did you see the fall?
No, I'm sure it won't. He's still pretty good.
There's a baseball appeared.
Baseball, rather large baseball, mate.
Yeah. Basketball.
There we go.
Oh,
we ball.
Fell. I saw Luke deducting points then, I think.
Oh, yeah. Fantastic.
Well done.
Well done, guys.
Sam and Benchley, the strangely talented unicyclist. Right,
okay,
guys.
Let's find out what these guys saw.
What do you think to the tap dancing granny?
Luke, what do you think of tap dancing granny?
5 out of 10.
Do you think she's pretty funny, though?
Yeah.
And the unicycling?
10.5.
Serena, what do you think of the tap dancing granny?
3.
3. Okay.
What about the unicyclist?
I put 9.
Ooh. Hannah. 6 and 10.5. Personally, my favourite tap dancing granny
so far.
It's very good. That's kind of pivotal to the post. Okay, let's have a next
time. I'm going over here because we got one more contestant in Strangely Talent. Oh, that's strange. That's quite a strange talent, isn't it? Look at that.
That's just stupid.
Okay, the final contestant on Strangely Talented.
Go on!
Alex Gratton with Die Biscuit Die! 19 years old. Right, Alex, take your stage. 1, 2, 3, go! Okay, what's going on here?
There he goes.
He's got a packet of digestives on his head.
That's good advertising. We'll get in trouble with the ITC for that one.
Here he goes. He's wiggling that booty.
Go on.
Shake that booty, boy. Yeah!
Woo!
The question on everyone's lips is,
Is
he going to eat the whole packet of digestives?
Go on.
Do you like digestives, guys?
No,
well, he's going to... Come on, look at this. Come on. Get the rest of the packet in there. A whole packet of digestives.
I think he's really gonna gag soon. I can see him doing a dry puke everywhere.
Come
all those biscuits
two more,
flying everywhere.
3 more biscuits and we'll let you stop. Go on, 3 more. Go on.
Go on.
It's making me feel ill.
You can get a job as a presenter if you carry on.
It's making me feel ill. This is terrible. Oh,
right, now you can stop booing.
Okay, stop,
that's enough. Alex.
How was it? Thank you very much. Alex Grattan, everyone.
Come over here.
So follow us. It's time to find out who the winner of Strangely Talented is this week. OK, we'll go through you one by one. Starting off with Hannah at the end, Dom.
OK, Hannah, let's see. OK, say the tap dancing granny safe. We've got the unicycle is 10 and biscuit eating 10. So neck and neck at the moment.
OK.
OK, we've got 10 for the unicycle. 10 and a half for the unicycling. Alex, 11, 5. So, OK, neck and neck. OK, let's go.
James.
Four and a half tap dancing and granny, 8 and 10 for the digestive eater, which is your favourite so far.
Digestive's in the lead.
Turn around.
Annie, what you got? You've got 6 for Sadie the granny. You've got 8 for the unicyclist. And look at that, 10,000.
10,000 out of 10,000 out of 10.
Right, Damien, let's have a look what you've got. You've got 4 for the granny, 8 for the unicyclists.
How many?
What is that?
Squilly, million, out of 10. And last but not least.
Oh, look at this. That's
look at this. 93 fourths. No, no, it's not. Is it 93 fourths?
93 and a quarter.
Yes.
Nine and three quarters.
Very good.
So that's 3 for the granny, 9 for the unicyclist, okay. 9 and three quarters for the.
Let's come over here. Let's have a confab.
Okay,
we have a winner. Can we have a drum roll, please?
Okay, the winner of the first Strangely Talented here on Dick and Dom in the Bungalow is the biscuit eater, Die Biscuit Die, Alex Grattan.
Now we know you've eaten lots of biscuits and the last thing you want is cake, but you can have your cake and eat it. You are as nutty as a fruitcake.
Come on, well done. Give him a round of applause, guys.
Well done, Grattan.
It's Alex Grattan, the biscuit eater. Eat the last biscuit. Go on, eat the last biscuit for us.
Go on.
Oh, you really don't want it. Okay, there'll be more Strangely Talented next week here on Dick and Dom in the Bungalow. We'll update you with the scoreboards in a bit as well. But right now, everybody, come on, do this again. Because it's our heroes. It's our heroes. Here's the Chucker Brothers. Chuckervision.
Get it? Why is it always me who has to do the pushing?
Because you don't get it.
Get what?
See, you still don't get it. Just keep pushing a while, and then I'll have a go.
Will you?
No problem. But I don't know why I should. Wasn't my fault the chain fell off. To me.
To you.
To me, then.
To you. Hey, are you gonna have a go?
No need. We're here.
I know we're here. If we weren't here, we'd be somewhere else. Where are we?
Well, we're outside a shop. We'll be able to get a chain for the bike in there.
Great. Does that mean no more pushing?
Exactly. See how I'm always thinking of you, Barry.
Thanks, Paul.
Don't mention it. Bring the shopping with you. Hi.
Hi.
You'll have to move that.
What?
That.
What?
That. Didn't you see the sign?
Oh, the sign.
Oh, the sign.
Move it, Barry.
I'll go and move it.
Lot of weather we're having for this time of year.
Geraniums don't like it.
Oh, well, they'd never do. Funny lot of people, them.
They're not people, they're flowers.
Oh, I wouldn't go that far.
There you go. What's up with him?
I think he's a bit mad. Do you know he thinks the Germans are a bunch of flowers?
Did he?
He did.
He's an odd man.
He's a very odd man. I think it's that hat he's wearing. Too tight, you know. Stops the circulation to the brain. They should never have banned balaclavas.
No.
Come on, it's nearly closing time.
Right. Hey! I meant move the bike!
They're a couple of troublemakers, if ever I saw one. Better keep an eye on those two.
Nice day for it.
So why would stopping the circulation make him up?
Well, it stands to reason, doesn't it? If your hat's too tight, it stops your blood flowing to your brain. Your brain dries up and turns into a walnut.
Walnut?
Oh, no thanks, they get stuck in my teeth. Hang on. Nah. On second thought, you better get some.
Excuse me, could you pass me that oil, please? Thank you very much. Have you ever thought of wearing a balaclava? Just a thought. Got it.
Good, is it working?
Yeah.
Good. Can't be too careful with squirters, you know. Now, where's the chains? Hey. Did you see those people at that campsite? Do you know, I smiled at them, I spoke to them, and they completely ignored me.
They're probably just sampling the great outdoors.
But we're indoors.
The great indoors, then. That's why they're confused.
That explains it.
Oh, dear.
Oh, dear, oh, dear. Do you know, that's the first sign of brain drying.
What is?
They're falling down.
What's the second sign?
They're standing up again, followed by falling down again. We better go, Barry.
Why?
You won't like the third sign.
Hey, you!
We'll be all right here for a while. Barry? Barry?
What?
Stop messing about. Get out here, quick. Now look what you've done.
Me?
Yes, get them picked up before somebody comes.
To you.
To me.
It's for you.
For me. Run! Quick, in here.
I'm not going in there.
Yeah, it's the last place you'll think of looking.
I don't care, that's for ladies.
Exactly. Great place to hide.
No, if there's somebody in there, I'll go all red and flustered.
But if somebody's in there, that we'll tell them that we're reporters from the Plumber's Nest Bend Weekly and that we've come to have a look at the plumbing.
I don't like the sound of that.
Don't listen then. Come on,
gentlemen,
get
it. The store is now closing. Please make your way to the nearest exit. Thank you.
Come on, I think it's safe.
Great. Can we go home now?
We better add. They haven't got what we came for anyway. We'll just have to push the bike all the way home, that's all.
I don't care, I just want to get out of here. It won't open.
That's because you're pushing instead of pulling.
Of course, silly me.
Silly you.
It still won't open.
If you want a job doing, do it yourself. Come out of the way. I know what the problem is.
What?
It's locked.
Oh, that's all right. What do you mean it's locked?
What I say, it's locked.
Well, open it. I want to go home.
Slight problem there, I'm afraid. We're locked in.
I don't want to be locked in.
Don't panic. You know what they say, when one door closes...
another one slams in your face.
Exactly. Now, there's got to be more than one exit on a place this size. All we've got to do is find it.
What about a fire exit?
Yeah. No, no, that's no good. We're not on fire.
Of course we're not. Just a minute.
What?
I've had a thought. If we're on the inside when we should be on the outside, then somebody outside might see us inside and think we're outsiders who's got inside, and they'll think we're burglars. They'll call the police. The police will come inside, take us outside and put us inside.
I've told you before, haven't I? Don't thought. I've never heard anything so ridiculous in all my life. Do we look anything like burglars? Honestly. Where would we be if I wasn't here to do the thinking for us?
On the outside, probably.
Probably. Don't start that. Now, come on, let's find a way out.
Well, shall we split ourselves up?
Ooh, no, that'd be messy. You go that way, I'll go this way, and we'll meet back here.
Right. Morning, sir. 10 bags of cement, was it?
Right, sir, just a moment.
With you in a moment, sir. I'll just stamp that for you. Bing bong. Here's a special announcement. This is Barry Chuckle. We're locked in a DIY store. Is anybody there? Help. Hey, look, a phone. I could ring somebody to get us out. Have a look. The manager. He should have a key.
Who is it?
It's me.
How can that be me? I'm me. What do you want?
I'm locked in a DIY store.
What a coincidence. So am I. Just a minute. Is that you, Barry?
No, it's me, Barry. Who are you?
It's Paul. You've got through to the manager's office.
Oh, great. Could you ask him if he could let us out, please?
What do you mean, can I ask him if he can let us out? The manager's not here. Just go and find a door.
Charming. Ah! Oh!
Oh, God, you found a door. Come on, what are we waiting for?
We'd better not. I think we should find another way out.
Nonsense. Get out of the way. I think you're right. Come on, let's find another way out. Make a bolt for it.
We haven't got time to make a bolt. Shall I fetch a padlock?
No. Come on.
Make sure they don't get back in again.
Oh, no!
Hey, where are you going?
Back in here. It's the last place they'll think of looking.
Locked in. What are we going to do?
Well, we'll just have to stay here for the night.
Stay the night?
Don't worry. We'll make ourselves comfortable.
Just like home?
Yes, we'll get ourselves to bed.
Yeah, but I'm not tired.
No, well, there's plenty to look at, isn't there? Have a look around. Look more like our Barry every day. What are you doing?
I'm having a bubble bath. I always have a bath before I go to bed.
Well, don't be long about it. Wake up, Barry. Time to put the cat out.
I'm already awake and we haven't got a cat.
Of course we haven't, silly me. Hey, now you're up, you can make a nice cup of tea.
I've already done it. And I've made us some bacon and eggs.
Oh, great. I'm starving. I could eat a horse.
Oh, sorry, I've only got bacon.
That'll do.
Hey, it's a good job I brought the shop in.
It is. Oh, here, I tell you what, there's nothing like sleeping outdoors to give you an appetite.
But we're not outdoors, we're indoors.
Of course we are, silly me. Just a minute. How did you cook that?
On the fire.
Fire? What about the sprinklers?
What are we going to do now?
Easy. We just keep out of everybody's way until they open the shop. Then we sneak out with the rest of the customers. Now let's find somewhere to hide. Have a look outside and see if anyone's around.
It's still all quiet.
Right. All we've got to do is hang about a bit and we'll be okay.
Right. Hey, what's that buzzing?
Ah, it's a wasp! Ah. Get out, quick!
Whoa! Oh. Ah.
Get out. Oops.
It was a wasp, you see.
Trouble is, you can't reason with them.
Wasp. I'll give you wasp.
No, thanks. We've just had one. Do you think we'll be able to reason with him?
I'm not going to hang about to find out. Come on! No, I can't run another step.
I'm too young to go to prison with a criminal CD.
You two.
Who two?
You two.
Us two?
Got you. Leave this to me, Mr. Manager, sir. I'll make sure they get what's coming to them.
Excellent. You two,
are our 1 millionth customers. And to honour that fact, we'd like to offer you a prize.
What?
Yes, what?
We'd like to offer you the chance to make a supermarket dash.
What's that?
You get 2 minutes to rush around the store, filling your trolleys with whatever you want. Everything you get, you keep.
I see. The only trouble is, we're too exhausted now, aren't we, Barry?
Yes, I'm completely exhausted.
Excuse me, sir. I've been following these two, and I'd like to see them get what's coming to them.
That's very nice of you to offer. Okay. You can do the dash on their behalf.
Me? I didn't mean...
A nice man.
A very nice man.
Oh, there's your trolley. You've got 2 minutes starting from now. And I want to see the trolley full.
Off you go. It's good, this. That was a stroke of luck, wasn't it, Barry?
Was. Mind you, we still haven't got what we went in for in the first place.
That's right, the chain. Never mind, we'll stop off on the way. Can we do a left at the next roundabout, please? What a nice man.
A very nice man.
Our heroes, yes, the Chucker brothers on Dick and Dom into Bungalow. These are the Bungalow heads, say oi!
Oi!
Yeah, and all morning we have been scoring, giving them points if they've done something good, and deducting them if they've done something bad. Let's have a look at the scoreboard, how it stands at the moment. Anu's got 27, Serena with 37, James in the lead at the moment with 42, there's Luke on 27, Damien on 39, and Hannah on 22. Ooh. Who do you reckon's gonna win?
Me.
Yeah. Me. What's going to happen is the Bungalow heads are actually going to stay in the bungalow tonight. Watch out for the moose, by the way, because he burps a lot. Yeah, and also watch out for the toilet. We'll find out about that in just a minute. Yeah, all right, shut your face. Now though, time for you to try and get more points, because tomorrow, remember, we'll find out who the overall winner of this prize is. Yes, the TV, the DVD, and the S Club 7 DVD too. Oh,
look at those prizes.
They're beautiful. Who wants that? Who wants that prize?
Me.
Oh, yeah, that's all of them then. Okay, fascinating factuality now.
Take my word for it. It's reality. Dick and Tom's fascinating factuality.
Right, what's going to happen here? We have our scientist in the lift. Please welcome scientist Pink and Floppy.
Hello there, Professor Pink and Floppy Hair.
Pink and Floppy Hair, yes. Right, basically, your chance now, guys, to earn 10 points each on each, whether you get each answer right. What Dom's going to do, Mr. Pink and Floppy's going to give you a fascinating fact. He's going to ask you whether it's true or false. You have to put your cards in the air. If you get it right, 10 points are awarded. Okay, Pink and Floppy. What's the first fact?
My first fascinating fact for all of you guys. Listen up carefully, you at the back. Yes, first fascinating fact is there are more people in the world than chickens. This is a picture of a chicken, just in case you forgot.
Okay, cards in the air, guys. Is it true or false?
Ooh.
Right, oh, Damien's having a bit of a...
Oh, no, I don't think decision. He might.
What are you going for? Come on, Damien.
Oh,
okay, the answer, Pink and Floppy.
It's actually true.
Oh, it's true. That means Damien, nothing. Anu, what did you put up? True. 10 points for Anu. 10 points for everyone else as well, because they all put true.
Liars, they're liars.
So no points for Damien there. But
okay,
second fact.
Next fascinating fact, bees. No, listen to this one. Bees can actually hear through their legs.
Right, true or false? There's a bee, if you didn't know what Willow.
Yeah, that
right,
was me.
True or false? Come on, come on.
Right, hold it up and make one decision. I've seen a lot of you cheating. One card only.
One card. And the answer, Pink and Floppy.
It's actually balls.
False! Yes. That means Damien has no points again, but 10 points to everyone else. James is going right to the top of the leaderboard here. Okay, your final fascinating fact.
Oh, the last one. The strongest muscle in the whole of your body is... your tongue.
True or false? Come on, cards in the air, quick as possible. Okay, false, and come on. Hannah. Right, what's the answer?
The answer is it's true.
Wrong. That means nobody gets any points. Okay, we'll add all them points to the scoreboard now.
Yes. I'm going to walk down the stairs.
Oh, okay, Pink and Floppy's off. Thank you, Pink and Floppy, and hopefully Dom will reappear. Hello, Dom. There he is.
There he is, there we are, fantastic. Oh, look at these glasses.
Right, guys, have you enjoyed today's show?
Yes.
What's been your favourite bit? Come on!
What's been your favourite? Did you enjoy Rent a Ghost? Yeah.
What about some of the things we've done in the bungalow? Which bit's been your best?
The bungalow.
Oh, the bungalow bogeyman.
Bungalow bogeyman. You like that one?
Yeah.
And have you told them how to do the magic trick yet? Have you kept it a secret?
Yeah, I kept it secret.
You kept it secret. Good go. Nice one.
What about? Okay, right. That's it. Thank you very much. We're going to now have a look. We've totted all those scores up from the last game, and we're going to have a look. We're going to have a look. Who's at the lead and who's right at the back? Here's the scoreboard.
47 for Anu.
Anu is. Serena with 57.
James with 62.
James is at the top of the moment. You could keep going up there for the TV.
Luke has got 47. Damien's got 39.
And Hannah with 42. That means, Damien, you are in last place at the moment,
Damien, yeah. So that means you, mate, have got to come with me because we've got a special surprise for you. All right? All right, so come on then. Up on your hind leg. Move forward, move forward. There we go. Okay, move forward. Come on, let's go. Come on.
So that has been the very first Dick and Dom in the Bungalow. Give us a cheer. Come on. Remember, we're going to be back tomorrow morning live on the CBBC channel, only on the CBBC channel, with more Rent-A-Ghost. There's Yvonne at the Yukon, more Chuckavision for you as well, and more madness right here in the Bungalow. And of course, the Bungalow heads will be sticking around, and we're going to keep awarding them points, deducting them points, to try and find out who the winner of that TV, DVD, and DVD player will be. You will find out right here tomorrow on Dick and Dom in the Bungalow. You best tune in 9 till 12. Hope you've enjoyed this morning. Right now, ladies and jelly spoons, boys and twirls, it is the finale of the show. It's the end. It's the fanfare. It's over to Dom in the lab.
Right. You ready? Goggles on, twirling goggles. Come on. Just hold them there. Ready? Go, Gunge in the toilet! Yeah, there! Fantastic!
Big Gunge!